Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, we're taking a look at Clockwise. Clockwise is a Chrome extension that essentially analyzes your Google Calendar in G Suite, bringing together all of the free time or focus time that you could be working and basically reallocating your meetings. We're going to be diving into the application today, also diving into where we found it and how you can get started on this application. So without further ado, guys, let's jump into Clockwise. So guys, before we dive in, I wanted to thank the sponsor for June 2019, and that is Bear Notes. Now, Bear is a writer and note taker application that is available on iPhone, iPad, and Mac. And it's a powerful application that will allow you to do anything from craft your next theatrical masterpiece to coordinating all of your notes for your next conference. Bear has a ton of features that include markdown editing, also hashtag note organization, which is really handy, and also a range of themes and sync in the pro experience. So Bear has a new feature, WordPress integration. So for bloggers, you can now publish to WordPress, which is pretty impressive. Definitely worth it if you are an avid blogger and use WordPress. So guys, you can check out Bear Notes in the description below. You can download them on iOS and Mac. Thanks so much to Bear for coming back on as a sponsor, and make sure to check them out in the description below. So here we are. As you can see, I'm on the blog post of the release about this, and obviously this is the article. It was actually posted by Greylock Partners, and Greylock, I believe, are also the investors behind, I believe it's Coda, and I remember that because of Reid Hoffman. But I'll double check and add it in the description below. But I actually first found it when I was browsing Twitter. I saw a couple of posts about it, and I thought just from this, you know, GIF preview, I was like, wow, this application looks pretty smart in terms of what it can do in allocating time and reallocating your time. And then I saw it on Product Hunt and was like, okay, I'm probably going to check it out now. It got above 600 upvotes and was product of the day. Now, this application aims to try and optimize your time by reallocating some meetings and also giving you this uninterrupted time, which is a concept by Cal Newport, who also developed the book Deep Work. And it's about working on longer sort of sessions to go deep inside of one piece of work. Now, obviously, this is only available with G Suite and Chrome. They did mention they will get an Office 365 integration. I believe it was up here. Yeah, Office 365, you can sign up on that link. But it also has a Slack application, which we'll dive into. But I've got it over here on my Google Calendar. So without further ado, guys, let's dive in. So the Clockwise integration appears on this right-hand side. And it's like this sort of like mini application that works with your G Suite. Now, you can bring in your personal calendar. There were a few cards here, and there was an option to connect with your personal calendar. And you can see that it brings it in, but obviously everything is highlighted as like busy or free. And as you can see, there's the actual meeting. So this was brought in by my Google Calendar, which was quite easy to do. Now, obviously, it will annotate anything you add in. So I added these two meetings here. And you can have this option called Clockwise Autopilot. So basically, it may be automatically changed if there's less disruptive times that become available. So obviously, you might not want that on, just to be clear, as you're getting started, because it might move stuff around. But you do have a range of options here, so you can allow it or you can not allow it, disable it. And you can also change the timing flexibility, so whether you want to move it in within the day or within the week at best. So obviously, if things become a bit too busy and you're losing out on those focus time sessions, then it will automatically move that meeting. So this is more designed for trying to analyze your calendar and work out how to optimize those longer sessions and these brown sort of, you know, focus time hours. So what's cool is if, for example, I added something in the middle of here and put Clockwise Autopilot on. Let's say I added another meeting 3 and press save. As you can see here, what it will do is it will sort of squash that focus time session, and it will start processing that this is a meeting, and it will begin to add it to the Clockwise calendar. So it should go purple in a moment. Yeah, there we go. So it goes purple, and you can see that the meeting here is part of that autofocus. So you can reschedule it up here like you would be able to do so. And that's quite simple. So what it just does and tries to do is just consistently analyze your calendar to find these longer blocks of time so that you can work on stuff. Now, obviously you got the assistant. It came up with a load of cards when I started, and it made it quite easier. But the real way you can improve this is actually when you go to schedule a meeting. So scheduling a meeting is quite easy. You can add attendees here, how long you want the meeting, whether you want it within this week. So that's cool. It gives you sort of like a bit of a slot to some extent. You can add a meeting room or without a meeting room. And what it will do is the autopilot will analyze your existing meetings and also all of the time there, gives you the best time. So apparently the best time is Tuesday, June 18th at 2:30 a.m. It's actually UK time, so it's 10 a.m. But actually analyzes that's the best time. And that's quite cool because it will move across the week if you need it to. But that's a really cool tool because you're actually just finding time that's already pretty busy. So it will sort of batch everything in a sort of organized manner. So that's one thing you can do with the new meeting or schedule meeting ability. You get what's called team analytics on the right. So if you and your team have a few people in your G Suite, you can basically see, you can click into each person, and per week, you can obviously see how much focus time they've had, how much fragmented time, and this is sort of fragmented time, anything in purple, how many meetings. So obviously you have to go through the schedule meeting feature through that, and other events that obviously will be allocated. So you can see sort of like an analysis, okay, my focus time on Wednesday is the best, and it basically will, you know, give you this rating, okay, good, great, high, and you can basically continue to improve that. So the goal is really to make sure you're, you know, continually analyzing and improving this figure so that you get it up, all the way up here. So if I go here and obviously go to the assistant, I can click and get access through that a little bit easier. And I do have a menu with settings, so I can invite coworkers, I can define my team members, who they are and what they do, and I can go into that autopilot meeting and actually see, you know, how much time I've saved in each one. Now we'll come to the Slack integration, but I'm going to go over to settings. One thing I had to do is actually go to the Europe time zone. And as you can see here, you can change your lunch times. You can also change your preferences, like when do you want to have open time? I tend to want to have open time in the afternoon, actually the morning, because obviously I don't want a lot of US calls during the afternoon. And I can also change the smart holds. So for example, the show focus time smart holds on my primary calendar. And you can have like travel time and lunch time. You've got a few integrations. So I've connected it obviously with my personal calendar, Slack integration. And you can really modify the coloring here if it's something that you really want to go detailed in. And you can change more of the account details and the invitations. So let's move to the Slack integration. So you can see here, I've got sync your calendar with Slack. So obviously this pops up. I won't show you what it does. I will show you how it works using some of the demonstration images. It's really simple. Whatever happens, it will update with your calendar. So your Slack status will have, for example, in an external meeting via Clockwise, and that will update your automatically do not disturb, so you won't get any notifications during that focus time. And it will also prepare you with a daily forecast. Now, I used to use an app that was in Slack that would send me a daily forecast to my Google Calendar every day. And this is really neat because it gives you an idea of how many meetings you've got, when your first meeting starts, and how much focus time you do have that day. And finally, you get other updates, like how much time you were successful, who you you know, were in meetings with, etc. So it's quite a neat application. So guys, I'm not a user of G Suite. I use my personal calendar to organize most of my stuff, but I will keep giving this a go. I think it's something that will probably improve over time. Not because I'm necessarily a bad user right now, but I don't have enough in my G Suite account for it to fully optimize, I think. So for me, this demo was more of a collective appreciation of the features. and I will probably be testing it out even more. But I see this application could be a good way for people that have got G Suites that are full and want to be able to coordinate a bit more, you know, dedicated time by reanalyzing meetings. So I would say give it a try. It's free, which is great. There's no plans at the moment. Not that I'm aware of anyway. But again, apparently teams that are in like Lyft and even Intercom and Asana and Twitter are using this one. So apparently it's got a lot of attention at the moment anyway. So guys, please do let me know in the comments below what you thought of Clockwise. I will see you guys in another video. Thanks again to Bear for being sponsors. If you guys want to check out more videos on Keep Productive, you can subscribe here on YouTube. If you like this video, hit the like button. There's so much stuff to do, guys. You probably won't even get time to do Clockwise. But I will see you guys very, very soon. So make sure you have a great week. Keep productive. And I'll see you guys very soon. Cheers, everyone.